Love. I think I'm in love.
Why is it all right for you to have a boyfriend, but not for me?
So long as you live under my roof, you live by my rules.
Finn's got my room.
Who would even send a love letter? That is so stupid.
Please, keep your voice down. This is where I work.
Don't tell me to keep my voice down.
If we're friends, and we're not friends.
Maybe. I don't want to be your friend.
We are...
married!
Can I tell you something? It was me who sent the letter to Finn.
Don't mention Friday to anyone.
Why are you looking at me?
I'm looking at everyone. Don't tell your brothers. Don't tell your sisters. Don't even tell my beds from school. At the end of the day...
Whatever, Chop. Dear Diary, the fight for Finn's delicious heart has begun. In the red corner, Chloe. Seen here looking at Finn like a black widow, sizing up how much Gaviscon she's gonna need after eating him whole. In the blue corner, see me. Finn so out of my league that no one would ever even suspect I liked him. They loved him. But since we had that amazing heart-to-heart at the party, my odds have shortened massively.
This fight is between the six of us. Put it in the vault, people. Lock it in the fucking vault.
We've even developed a secret mode of communication. To use every ounce of my willpower not to move his hand over just a few inches and ask him to write out all of War and Peace.
Yeah, to cut his bum out.
Oh my God.
Hi, Ray. Hi, Chloe. Hi, everyone.
Hi.
What are you doing here?
I'm booking the function room for Saturday. Oh, Ray's friends. This is my new husband, Kareem.
Congratulations. Pleased to meet you.
Well, we're getting the marriage blessed, and then we're going to come here and have the reception afterwards. So you're all invited, of course.
They can't, they're busy.
We're not busy at all. That's wonderful, Mrs. Earl. Congratulations.
Thank you, Chloe, but actually, my name is Mrs. Bushtat now.
Oh, Bushtat. Does that mean your name is Ray Bushtat?
No, it doesn't.
This is so exciting. We can use it as a wind-down session after the rave.
What did you say?
Nothing.
So did you say rave?
Calories a minute does high-intensity sex burn?
18.
So how long would I have to have sex to burn off a six-pack of wagon wheels?
Jammy or normal?
Jammy.
Jammy wagon wheels are 167 cal.
6,002.
18 cal a minute, just under an hour.
Ooh, maybe I should get Dr. Nick to cancel his 1 o'clock.
Hand jobs are supposed to be exhausting too. I've heard you sometimes have to change arms halfway through.
So what you're saying is I could essentially sex myself thin?
Well, you could eat 2 roast dinners, have sex for an hour, throw in a couple of hand jobs, and you'd actually be in minus calories.
Well, what is not to like? Where do I sign?
What day is it?
It's Wednesday, the 21st
of August, 1996. Dear Diary, I want to be more like Ray. Then my life will be full of things like boys. Rather than things like how many calories things contain. Now to lose those calories.
I want you to start trying to drink at least 2 of these a day.
They taste like tar.
Ticks. Your BMI has dropped again. It's dropped significantly. You become in danger of falling very ill, okay? There's a risk of organ failure, of heart problems, hormone problems, problems with your brain. Angie said you refused solids for the last few days.
I don't like people watching me eat.
You're on supervised eating tics. It's her job to watch you eat. If you don't start eating in the next few days, if your weight doesn't stabilize, I'm gonna have to put you on a tube feed tics. I really, really don't wanna have to do that. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So how have you been since our last session? You scared? You have to let go, Tix. It's okay to lose control, sometimes. You don't have to worry all the time, you don't have to count calories. Tell me something that makes you feel good. Anything.
Ray.
Ray, great. So supposing I set up a date between you and Ray for dinner.
She'd like that. I'd like that. It'd have to be Ray, though.
Because I said no, and that means no.
Well, everyone's going. It's not like an illegal rave anyway. It's more like a big dance event.
You're not going. I know sometimes I tell you to do things and you ignore me. Right, well, this isn't going to be one of those times. Anyway, what do you think Kester would say if you told him you were going to a rave?
He'd say, go for it. I know Kester, and he would love the idea of me enjoying myself. Because he's not a complete ball break.
Thank you, I'm not deaf. Right, how does it look?
Oh, great. I look like a cross between a profiterole and a prolapse colon.
I love it. I absolutely love it.
Oh. Well, what about this one?
It's too expensive.
But I love it. If everyone's going to be there, I have to look nice.
Right, Ray, when I say no to something, it doesn't mean keep arguing. It means end of discussion.
I think I'm gonna be sick.
Oh, don't be so dramatic.
You always wonder what it would be like to sit in front of a doctor and hear the worst possible news. How you'd cope, how you'd feel.
Ray, I'm afraid you're gonna have to stop drinking alcohol.
Why?
The meds we switch you over to, some people feel very nauseous if they drink on them, especially at first.
Why, so it's nothing serious?
What? I want to go back to the old ones.
No, I wasn't happy with the SSRIs. You said yourself they make you feel drowsy.
I'd rather feel drowsy than feel sick.
That's fine, she can just give up the booze.
This is bullshit.
Ray!
We can review your meds in the next few weeks, but changing them or stopping them now is really not a good idea.
Oh, Dr. Nick, I meant to say, I got married last week.
Oh, wow, great, congratulations.
Are we all right?
Yeah.
When you're sick, you don't belong to yourself anymore. You don't get a say. Every doctor is another parent. Every ward's another classroom. Every pill, another piece of their bollocks that you have to swallow. So that was it. No booze because of my pills, and no rave because of my cow bag of a mum. You never know. Maybe the rave would be shit. Who was I kidding? It was gonna be fucking amazing. The perfect opportunity to lick the fillings from his teeth, to suck on his fingers, to grab hold of his firm...
What are you thinking about?
I'm thinking how I'm going to tell you that you smell a BO.
I'm sure you'll find something to say.
Oh, shit, there's Kendo.
Who's Kendo?
Some twat dealer from Dalehead.
Do I look all right?
Do you mean if you look all right, he's a scumbag?
All right, ladies? All right, Chopper?
All right, Kendo.
You tell your fucking brother I'm gonna smash his face in when I see him, yeah? I'm only joking. How is the cunt?
He's all right.
You want some pills for Friday?
Yeah, yeah, sounds good.
Talk around tomorrow and I'll see what I can do for you, yeah? In a bit. See you later, girls.
What are you getting drugs for?
It's a rave, innit?
You think, can I get a ride on the back of your scooter?
Yeah, of course, no problem.
There's room for you to all go in the one car.
What are you talking about?
I'm not going.
What?
Why?
Is it because your mum?
I'm not going if Ray's not going.
I'm not going if Ray's not going either.
Whoa, 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 no, no, no one is backing out of this.
Ray, come here. Ray, what's going on? My mum won't let me go. Ray, listen to everyone. You know, you've got to go. Ray, you're always being reminded of how sick you were. It's just making you worse. You know, you even said yourself you're getting better. You know, you and Finn are getting close. Yeah, he's a good laugh. Does he ever mention me?
Do you know, really?
What do you reckon he'd do if I tried to kiss him?
Oh, should I know what he'd do?
Can you imagine sleeping with him? You're a fucking bitch.
That's disgusting.
It's what you said about Jarvis Cocker last week, so...
It's still disgusting.
Well, you're disgusting.
Right, I'm off. Right, come round to mine tomorrow if you want.
Why?
Because I've got some really crap reggae I want to show you. And you can give me some personal hygiene tips.
What?
Round one, two.
Rachel, come name. Special bird for you.
No, thanks.
Oh, Ray, come and name a bird.
What's the matter with you? You're not still in a mood, are you, about that rave? I'd like to see Kester's face if he thought I was letting you go to a rave.
Stop pretending like you know him. I already told you, he wants me to have a life.
Are you going to name this bird or not?
You know, they might not even like each other and you've got them all cooped up together.
Yeah, well, a lot of us have to live like that, so...
Yeah, well, it doesn't make it right. You shouldn't cage up wild animals.
Just name the bird.
Fine. He's called Mandela.
Mandela? Yes, like Nelson. I like.
So you're going to the rave tomorrow?
Doesn't look like it.
Will you go out with me?
Where?
At the hospital. A dinner date.
I'm going to try and have some proper food.
Kester says I need to lose control.
I love Kester for saying that. How do I lose control? Do something that you've always
wanted to do, but you've been too scared of.
Well, can you think of anything?
Maybe.
Hiya, Tix. Hiya.
What are you up to?
Bit of admin.
Do you want to go to the lake with me later?
Me?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. What time?
Four-ish.
Four-ish, okay. Cool.
Even his house was a bit sexy. Oh, God, stop. No craziness. Stop the craziness. I'm breathing too deep. I'm hyperventilating. Put your hands on something flat.
Pulled a hamstring. I'm stretching it out.
Yeah, go up to a room. My dad says he'll bend your hair for weeks.
His bedroom. My God, this was it. about to enter the lion's den. Round two.
Well, I didn't want to miss out on listening to some reggae.
Yeah, because you love reggae.
Well, I don't particularly like any type of music best. I just like good music, you know? Finn, I love this song.
Who do you like best, Chloe? Morrissey or the lead singer of the Smiths?
Well, depends what mood I'm in. What?
In your face, Chloe.
Who wants a beer?
I will.
Yeah?
No, I'm all right.
Serious?
I'm all right. Don't be boring. Don't be a weirdo.
I can't believe I asked a boy out. Finally, I'm going to be able to talk to Ray about kissing and sex things and flirting and love. Just like a normal girl. Maybe I can be normal.
So what about Red then? Mum not letting you go?
It's complicated.
It really would be shit if you don't come.
Well, the rest of the gang is still going. You're still gonna have a good time.
The rest of the gang would fall apart if you're not there. You are the gang. No, I mean that, Ray. Everyone else has got too much stuff going on. You're the most, you know, normal.
That's bollocks.
It's true. Anyway, you've got to go. I won't take no for an answer because...
Because what? No, we're just, what's up? I don't feel very well.
Well, do you want me to see if my dad will give you a lift home?
Oh, God. No vomitorium.
You like this. I got really glad at a status quo consequence.
Round two to Chloe.
Just relax. He's just a boy. Ray would say something funny. Maybe I should tell a joke? No. Don't tell any jokes. Just make conversation.
What do you want to talk about?
Ducks. They're one of my favourite things, ducks. I mean, when you think about a duck, they're just so chilled out.
They're not chilled out. I've seen them fight.
Yeah, but once they're done flapping their wings and splashing about and stuff, they just go back to being so chilled out.
Hey, do you know what we should do?
What?
We should become ducks. We go into the pond.
Danny, no, we'll see you from the windows.
I fear nothing.
Come on, then.
Lose control. Let go. Lose control. Let go.
Lose control. Let go. Lose control. Let go. Pills, fucking doctors. How was I supposed to compete for Finn when I couldn't go anywhere? Couldn't do anything. At least there was one adult on the planet who understood.
It's a load of crap. I mean, I'm 16. Everyone else is going. And she's all like, oh, you can't go because you're different. You shouldn't be exposing yourself to that kind of situation. She even used you in an argument. Oh, think of what Kester would say.
What did you think I'd say?
She said that you would think it was a bad idea. But she doesn't know about everything we talk about in it. She doesn't know about all the work we've done on me being brave and confident. She just reminds me that I'm ill all the time.
I agree with your mum. I think it's a terrible idea.
You don't think that.
You're recovering from a serious illness. If you've broken your leg, would you try and run a marathon 2 months later?
Do you still think I'm a mess then?
I don't think you're a mess. I think you need to take care of yourself.
I need to take care of myself. Who were you arguing with last week in the car park? I saw you. Was it your wife? How am I supposed to listen to someone whose life is a bigger mess than mine? What is even the point of these sessions? Seriously.
To find out what pushed you over the edge and to stop it from happening again.
Oh, you're always asking questions. Why did you hurt yourself? Why did you go crazy? Sometimes there is no why. I just did. And being here and being asked about it every bloody day is what's keeping it alive.
Look, I know this is painful.
Are you even listening to me? I was bored. I was lonely. I had no mates. Now I'm finally popular. And you just want to make me feel different again. I don't want to come here anymore.
You're not obliged to come here, Ray. But I think that would be a bad idea. I think we're making some real progress here.
What would happen if I walked out that door right now and never came back? Aren't you going to try and say something insightful to make me stay?
Do you think perhaps your anger is born out of frustration with yourself? That you're angry and frustrated with yourself for being ill? You see, that is not something you're entirely responsible for.
Friday, the 23rd of August. Dear Diary. Oh, bollocks to it.
Morning. Morning.
What?
What happened? Someone let all the birds out of the cage. That's what happened.
Who did? Why would someone do such a thing?
I don't know. Maybe you could tell me why someone would do such a thing.
Oh, my.
Do you want to tell me why you did it?
Well, I didn't know that they'd die.
Well, what did you think they'd do? Fly back to the Bahamas? Check in at the local RSPB? Kareem is in bits. He built this because he doesn't know many people here. He wanted a project, something nice, so he didn't feel so trapped.
I did it because they shouldn't be in a cage. The birds, they're not toys.
No, no, you did it to get back at me for not letting you go to the rave, didn't you? Well, is it any wonder I won't let you go when you do things like this, when you behave like a mental case?
Don't call me a mental case.
Well, you know what I meant?
Don't you ever call me a fucking mental case.
Don't talk to me like that, Ray. I'm your mum. I meant you need to start behaving like an adult instead of behaving like a child.
Yeah? Well, maybe you need to start behaving like my mum instead of behaving like a twat.
I'm sorry, Ray.
Save it.
Where are you going?
No, anywhere. Away from you, away from him.
Ray, don't go. Let's talk about this. I'm really sorry. Why don't you slap me and then we're even?
I don't want to slap you. I don't even want to look at you.
Known I'd have to run away from home at some point. I'd always planned that I'd go and stop at Chloe's. We'd be like sisters. I'd have a normal family. But things change.
Makes everything all right. I reckon it'll be all right, you know, in a couple of days. We both had some space or whatever.
Thanks for letting me stop.
It's all right. My dad's ironing the sheets for the spare room as we speak.
Oh, please don't let him do that.
I won't try and stop him.
So what time's the rave?
Probably set off in about an hour. Are you thinking of coming?
No. No, I'm not. It would mess up all the lifts and stuff.
Why would it bollocks? No, I'll tell Chloe to jump in with Chop. And you can get on the scooter with me.
I can't even dip my toe in a pond. I can't even lose control enough to get my feet wet.
I'll never be normal. I'll never be able to talk to Ray about kissing and flirting and love. I'll never be like...
Ray?
It's me.
What are you doing in here?
Hiding. Why, what are you doing in here?
Hiding.
I thought you'd be getting ready for your big, big date with Ray.
I'm not going. Please don't try and convince me to go.
I once treated a young boy, he's about 7 years old. He used to pull down on his testicles whenever he was upset. I mean, really yanked down. It was truly eye-watering to behold. Then one day I asked him a difficult question. He pulled down so hard upon them that he had to go to hospital.
That's crazy.
You'd be surprised what lengths people will go to not to face what's real and painful inside them. Then that's what my job is. I'm essentially a torturer. This is where you say that I'm not a torturer, but that I'm actually quite lovely. My methods of torture are asking you to trust people, asking you to lose control. But if I'd been treated the way you have been treated by people, I'd want to sit in a toilet night away from the rest of the world as well.
You are sitting in a toilet.
It's really quite nice, actually. I can see why you and Ray hang out here.
I do trust people, you know. I trust Ray.
Well, then maybe you should have dinner with her.
Try and have a good night. Enjoy yourself. Hello?
What's going on with you two?
What do you mean?
You look like a couple.
Come on, Chloe. You look like a better couple than they do.
In keeping a diary when you're too scared to even do anything, when your life is boring, when the only things you know are how many calories things contain.
and how to lose them.
Seen Chop?
Chop? Chop!
Oh, Jesus, Ray, I'm so fucked.
Yeah. Me too.
Where the fuck is he? Boy, it's a constant flight risk.
Right. Just leave it. Right, he'll come back when he's ready. And I need another drink.
No.
So come on.
Oh, so come on.
Come on.
Come on.
Let's go. Oh. Why are you laughing?
No way, I'll come there.
Oh, pussy. Right. I need to kiss him tonight, babes.
talking about? You're fucked.
No! I'm all right. I need to kiss him and I need to tell him. He needs to know.
Kiss off.
How you feeling?
Right, twice boiled shit.
Can you remember anything from last night?
A little.
I can't remember a thing. You stopping at Finn's, right?
No, just take me home.
What about your mum?
If tea makes everything better, I need an ocean of it. I need all the tea in China. Sorry I haven't written for a while, but, well, what do you expect? I'm unreliable. I'm a mess. I'm mental.
Hello, Mandela.
I missed it. Is she there? Can I speak to her?
No, it's not. She...
What?
She collapsed this morning.
Is it serious?
How quickly can you get to the hospital?
And it's the final one in the series next Monday night at 10. And to read exclusive content from Ray's diary, you can also find related help and support links at e4.com/mymadfatdiary. Next, though, another sort of 90s rave to take that in a caravan park in the Inbetweeners.